Well, the opportunity was presented to me by a recruiting team that came over to South Africa, initially on a golf tour. And they were just handing out expression of interest forms as to, you know, if you were interested in joining the Royal Marines, this is the route to take, this is what you need to do, and, you know, the rest is up to you. I took that as another challenge, and I thought, well, that would be a great, you know, sort of string to my bow to add to my life sort of accomplishments and goals. And I've always wanted to be a military man. However, in South Africa, things were falling by the wayside as to the rank structures were, you know, you weren't able to progress as best as you were back in the days. The discipline was falling away. Just the whole structure of the military wasn't as strong as it used to be. So knowing that coming over to England to join the Royal Marines, the best fighting force in the world, and the longest and hardest NATO training in the world, was that challenge that I decided to accept and embark upon. In the process of doing that, I made a promise to myself. As you say, it's coming over. I sold everything off, cleared all my, you know, debts. I just bought a brand new car and sorted everything out before leaving. Packed my bags and I realized I didn't really have much as a teenager growing up. One bag on my back with some clothing items in and £100 in my pocket. Came over to the UK knowing that my goal and my only goal was to join the Royal Marines. And I came over with the intention on doing it, and there was no point of return for me. I had no exit strategy, no return ticket, no get out of jail free card. It was do or die. And that, I think, is what led me to pursue the career that I did, and to adapt that state of mind that I did, and the mental attitude, which was then, how can I say, doubled, if not tripled, along the way within my military career. So embarking along that journey, I think, was the best thing that I could have ever done. And it's opened up the world to opportunities that I've taken head on. A lot of people ask me why I always choose the most difficult route. And I tend to ask them the question, why do you always assume I see two routes? There's only one route for me, and that's the hard route, the route that I choose, the route that I am going to succeed in, regardless of the outcome that other people may think I'm going to achieve. There's only one end goal and outcome for me. And that's all the way or nothing at all. So I got injured very early stages of my Royal Marine training. I think it was week five, I think it was, where I went over on my ankle with severe tendon rupture and strain to my ligaments surrounding the ankle and the stability of it. So I couldn't progress within the early stages of my training. The backlash from that was I was overcompensating, so everything I was trying to do was putting more pressure on the opposite side of my body, and I encountered knee issues and problems. So with that problematic additive to it, it sort of put me in a dark slumber where I was in a holding company called Hunter Company, where it was injured recruits that were going through training at the time. A lot of people landed up in that troop, and that was just due to the arduous training that we were put through. During my time there, I had spoken to people through different stages of their training, some were at the early stages, some in the middle, and some at the latter stages. And each person still had that one focus in mind, and that was the ultimate wearing of that green beret at the end. And regardless of where they were, what their injury was, or how long they had been there for, they all still had that same goal. And I thought, well, it's a great goal to have, but that's not the only thing that we need, you know, is to get out there, achieve our green beret, and become a Royal Marine. But I think it was more so overcoming whatever it was holding you back, whether it be the injury, whether it be the mental block stopping you from progressing. And I think that's where my mindset again kicked up a gear from all the injuries that I had previously, the encounters that I had back in South Africa with the stabbing, the the feet on fire. That's when I put it all into play and created that state of mind which I've pursued and followed throughout my whole career. I'd say the strongest attribute that you would need is the mindset of a warrior, of an absolute lion, the toughest of the tough. And it's only because your mind is what is going to carry you through. It is the strongest muscle in your body. You could take Marines, put them side by side. Not all of them look like me. Not all of them are 6'3", monstrous muscles on them. We had some, of my best friends, half my size, half my weight, half my height, and the exact same capabilities at the end of it. We passed the exact same testing. So the standards never dropped. There was always a set criteria that you had to meet. And regardless of who they were or their physical look or shape, it was their mind that got them to that end goal. So I'd say you have to be, I suppose you have to have the mental fortitude of, the strongest possible outcome that you can have. I mean, it's one of those that you're given a test that everyone has to pass with the same criteria as I mentioned previously. And different capabilities, different body shapes, sizes, backgrounds, and you've all just got to get through it. It's your mindset that takes you to that next level or that criteria that you have to meet. I think the body is what you make it. You can always train to become an ultra marathon runner. You could train to become a strongman competitor and lifter or power lifter. You could train to become the fastest swimmer. But your mind is the strongest part of your body because it's something that is forever developing. And if you don't take control of it, it could make or break you within an instant. It's got the ability to bring the strongest men to their knees, and it's got the ability to lift the weakest person to the heights of, the highest towers. So it's something that you've really got to use to your advantage. Being the strongest muscle, utilize it. Make it your friend. Use it to the best of your ability, to what you can, for whatever goals are set out in front of you, to whatever obstacles are set out in front of you. And like I've always said, overcoming things, it's just down to the state of mind that you've got and that you persevere and push through, whether it be a sticky situation or, a great one.